Hello, I'm Maria Ressa. Welcome to Hashtag PH Vote. Joining us today is Team Pinoy's Risa Ontiveros. For two terms, she was the party list representative of Akbayan. She advocated, she pushed for the cheaper medicine law, Carper law, that's among others. She ran on a platform of women and youth empowerment, and she still does. She is most visible, however, as an advocate for the reproductive health bill. After hovering between 13th to 18th place in previous surveys, Risa makes it to the Magic 12 for the first time. Welcome, Risa.
Salamat, Maria.
It's good to have you here. It's been fascinating watching you. In the 2010 elections, the survey before, you were number 19.
Right.
And you finished number 13 in 2010.
A hair's breadth away, 900,000 votes short, 5% of the electorate. Short.
And now, what are we seeing now?
Oh my gosh, lumulundag kami, lumuha nung pumasok yung recent Pulse Asia survey results, that we really needed that break. So I'm still so happy, but I have to confess, it's guarded optimism I feel. Hirap pa rin. So I'm still sustaining my call, my appeal to my fellow ordinary citizens na mag-wage ng people power sa balota. I don't tire of saying na wala akong mabigat na apelido, wala akong malaking pera, pero may bit-bit naman akong track record nitong pakikipaglaban at mga aspirasyon din ng ordinaryong mamamayan. So I'm appealing to them, tulungan niyo ako, and maybe this time around, we can get an ordinary citizen to the Senate at mula dun, ipagpatuloy yung mga laban natin.
Well, you were at the forefront of the fight for the RH law. But now that could have a backlash against you. The church is campaigning relatively actively. There's Team Patay, Team Buhay. Text messages are going around. How do you see this playing out? How will it affect the final days?
I think, if at all, it will affect the final days in a positive way. Yeah, I think magdadagdag siya ng ekstrang sipa sa home stretch, because if the surveys are to be believed, and I do have faith in them, the surveys about the then RH bill were consistently highly in favor, and I believe even among my fellow Catholics. So palagay ko yung mga surveys noon tungkol sa RH, then RH bill, will be reflected in the only survey that matters regarding elections, which will come in on May 13. Kaya ganun din yung panawagan ko sa mga kapwa-Katoliko ko naman. Let's use our conscience, gamitin yung ating pananampalataya para labanan yung kahirapan, labanan yung korupsyon, wag labanan yung karapatan ng kababaihan. And for me, that's the real conscience vote.
What have you learned from 2010 to now?
A lot! 2010 taught me, first of all, prepare early. Well, time-wise speaking, it wasn't possible then kasi President Cory died September, President Noy stepped up to being a presidential October.
Right.
Doon siya nag-imbita, diniskusyon namin sa Akbayan. So practically, end of the year, kami naghanda.
Right.
So it was, you know, a few months before the campaign proper started. Ngayon, dahil maaga din, mas maaga din siya nakapag-imbita, we were able to start preparing earlier. Since middle of last year, we were on pre-campaign mode. Tapos, lesson number two, keep on reaching out even more, even beyond what we were able to do before. More and more varied persons and groups who will vote or campaign for me, who will contribute the resources for a massive effort, nationwide effort like this. So yun yung dalawang importanteng leksyon na baon ko sa 2010, which I've tried, my whole team has tried to put to good use this time around.
What have you learned about the Filipino voter during this campaign period?
Yung isang talagang napansin ko about Filipino voters, and I think it's it comes out because they represent Filipino citizens in general, the two sides of the reality we live with every day. Hirap pa rin ang tao, hirap pa rin ang botante, kahit panahon ng eleksyon. The old issues of poverty, marginalization, disenfranchisement, damang-dama pa rin ang tao yan. NSCB said as much, 3 out of 10 Filipino families still in extreme poverty.
Correct.
That's a major wake-up call and a major rallying cry for us to intensify poverty alleviation programs. Pero the other side, at the same time, hindi ito schizophrenia. It's a dual reality we Filipinos live with, and it comes out even in our behavior as voters, as election participants. Ibang klaseng pag-asa, Maria, This is the first time in a long time that people can say at the same time na hirap pa rin ako, but at the same time, sinasabi nila sa mga survey, for example, same time next year, things will be better. Pambihira yon, nakakapangilabot sila. It means that we are coming face to face very graphically with these historical deep problems, pero nararamdaman yung kapangyarihan natin to finally do something decisive about it and put us on a yung isang irreversible track tungo sa reforma at tungo sa pagiging moderno at maunlad na bansa.
God, I hope you're right.
Yeah, I hope I'm right too.
When you're, been running the campaign, I mean, you've had to figure out strategy. You're a very strong, smart woman, but that doesn't necessarily sell to the voters.
Right.
How did you handle it? How did your campaign strategy handle this?
Yung strength, siguro natutulungan din ako dahil Ilongga din ako. So kahit malakas palaban, malambing lumalabas, natatanong nga ako, nagagalit ka ba? Oo naman, Maria, nagagalit ako. Tao lang ako, like everyone. So the strength at least comes across in a way that isn't threatening, at least not to everyone. At tingin ko, nagre-resonate ang tao sa strength ko kasi may lakas din ang bawat Pilipino. Grabe, for us to have survived what we have survived, for us to have waged the battles we have waged in the past many decades, and to keep on hoping and to keep on fighting, galing ako sa mamamayan din. Kaya ganun din yung pagkatao ko. And then yung pagiging smart natin bilang mga babae, may common sense din ng tao eh. Despite the patronage, the corruption we are struggling against, and how that plays very cynically into how elections are run, yung presumption na people's votes can just be bought, na yung pagtitiwala nila can just be bought and marshaled for traditional, elite, even trapo interests, I think people know better. And I'm not trying to, and I don't think, I hope I'm not romanticizing people. Palagay ko, people do know better. At yung smarts na yon, yung street smarts na yon, lumalabas sa election. And I'm hoping it will come out even stronger in these elections.
It will be great to see that. But yeah, with campaign handlers handling you, how much of the real Risa is there, and how much of it have you had to blunt?
The real Risa is a raw material na alam nung mga kasama ko, nung campaign managers ko, na that's a starting point that they have to work with, that we can use. And that's how I've been presenting myself to the public. Ano ba talaga ako talaga? Lalo na yung esensya ko ng pagiging palaban. To the point na pati yung alam pa ko, palaban din. Yung tempering, I think we also worked with the fact na Ilongga ako. So, kaya yun na yung, kahit hindi pa itanong, yun na yung sagot dun sa pag-wonder ng mga tao, nagagalit ba siya? Bakit nagsasalita na siya passionately pero parang malumanay pa rin? So, yung pagiging malambing, I think there was a natural tempering effect there na ginamit. Kaya yung slogan ko rin na paglalaban ka, aalagaan ka. So, bilang babae din, we fight for things but we take care also of the people around us.
Right.
So, those were at least two factors na we worked with, and we tried to craft properly sa mensahe, especially with advice coming in from concerned people, mga advisors na paano dapat i-sharpen, i-tighten ang message, paano dapat ipahayag ng epektibo sa tao.
I hope you don't mind. I'm going to just go. One of the, we did a story on how the message that was ultimately used for Nancy Binay was originally crafted for you, being the nanay, being a nanay, but that you turned it down, and then Nancy Binay picked it up, and she's using it. Why did you turn it down?
Siguro I chose an even broader identity, yung babae. Of course, bilang babae, ako mismo, nanay ako, I have 4 kids, and I'm raising them as a solo mom. And that has been a way for me to touch base talaga sa andaming solo mom sa ating bansa, Maria. At the same time, hindi pa lahat, or hindi naman lahat ng babae ay mga nanay, pero lahat naman tayo may nanay, and meron tayong nurturing factor about our pagkatao. Kaya yun yung na-capture naman nung aalagaan ka. So, at saka yung feedback na ang pagkakilala talaga ng mga tao sa akin ay babaeng palaban. Yes. I wanted to stay faithful to that, na kung ano ang pagkakilala ng tao sa pagkatao ko talaga, I wanted to speak with them, to them with this voice. I wanted to be present to them with this face or this persona.
You have a track record, mm-hmm. Courage, you were a fighter. How do you explain the Nancy Binay's rise? Mm-hmm. And again, I hate to just point out because you're two women, but yeah. I mean, again, this seems to be two faces mm-hmm. of the Filipino voter. How do you point out to, you know, Nancy Binay? How do you compare this? What do you make of it?
Well, ang sabi nila, kaya siya malakas, mataas pati sa mga surveys. Syempre, yung apelido niya. Yun yung
name recall,
massive, yung popularity right? ng pangalan. Pangalawa, yung association ng mga respondents dun sa pangalan sa delivery of services. So it ties in with what I was saying about itong 30% ng mga pamilya nasa extreme poverty pa. Ano siya, it's both an affirmation dun sa poverty alleviation programs ng administrasyon ni President Noy, pero it's practically a demand na mas i-intensify itong mga poverty alleviation programs. Kasi whether for sa isang particular na kandidato o sa isang administrasyon, yun talagang malakas na panghatak sa appreciation ng tao. Siyempre, kasi hirap ang tao.
Yes.
And with the 4Ps, with the PhilHealth, with the K-12 rolled out and, you know, garnering more participants and hopefully beneficiaries, syempre tumataas ang expectation na these will be institutionalized and deliver for the long term.